guys, what is up? Charlie Pangas here. So today, I decided to do some prints for Street Dwellers. I'm making some more dope shit t-shirts. That's what I call it. The shirt actually says make dope shit. And I love that design so much. And I know you guys saw it in the last video. But yeah, I'm printing more in this video. You guys already know that I have the Ricoh RI1000. And spoiler alert, it's amazing. Everything really is software, guys. If you know how to use the program and set it up correctly for the best prints, you're gonna get the best prints. But if you don't know how to use it, then you're gonna get pretty bad prints. So, you know, for the most part, it is dummy proof. But yeah, I just wanted to give you guys an update on this. Have I had any issues with it so far? Nope, no issues at all. Everything has worked flawlessly. The maintenance on this thing is so easy. It literally tells you what to do on this screen right here. Let me show you where the screen is. It tells you what to do. Come on, change lighting. Anyway, this screen right here is where you do everything. I know it's a little blown out right now, but it works amazing and I haven't had any issues. I've already done a couple cleans on it. I cleaned the print heads. I cleaned the all the other components. Everything is really easy. This platen right here is also super easy to clean because you just take it off. It comes off, it's a magnet. I can't do it with one hand, but it does come off. Really easy to clean as well if there's any ink on there. Maintenance, super easy, which is really important because when you're doing large production and you're doing a lot of printing, you really don't have time to worry about a machine that's difficult to use and clean. So I can say with certainty that the machine just is so easy to clean, it's ridiculous. So you won't have a problem there. Totally worth the money that this thing costs. Honestly, it's way worth the investment. This thing's a workhorse. All I gotta say is don't listen to whatever you hear on the internet about the Ricoh RI1000 or Anajet or Ricoh in general, because they really did step up their game with this machine. It's phenomenal. But anyway, today I decided to do some more prints. This is a terrible idea, by the way. Never put your face this close to a heat press. You should definitely not try this at home, but I wanted to talk to you guys real quick. So what I'm doing right now is I just pre-treated my garment using this pre-treat station. And now what I'm going to do is actually pre-cure it for 15 seconds. So I'm just gonna put the shirt on there pretty easily, nothing to it, and don't burn your nose, obviously. There's definitely a better method of doing this, but we're gonna figure that out in time. Once you have the shirt on there, you just wanna like hover over it for 15 seconds. That's what I'm doing. So the water in this pre-treat liquid can evaporate a little bit. So 15 seconds is all you really need, I guess. So this is like the first part, right, that you wanna do. You wanna make sure your pre-treat is cured correctly, and then you can put it on this platen, which you guys are sitting on right now, and you can start printing. So we're gonna make a make dope shit shirt for Street Dwellers right now. It's really freaking exciting, honestly, that I can even do this. I don't have a cameraman, so that's why I cannot do all this stuff by myself. I'm trying my hardest to get the best angles and stuff, but again, it's really hard when it's like you're just you doing it. If you guys are in Southern California and you live near Redlands, or Yucaipa area, or near LA at least, let me know if you guys wanna be my camera guy. We can work out something. That'd be kinda awesome, actually. But anyway, so what I wanna do now is I have my pre-treated shirt. The style I'm printing on right now is by Bella Canvas, obviously. And I print everything with Street Dwellers on Bella Canvas. I make sure everything's the highest quality possible. And this is the 3001U style. So if you guys wanna check that out, I will link Bella Canvas in the description below. Definitely recommend you guys check them out. But anyway, we're gonna do a make dope shit print on it now and see what happens. I'm gonna try to get the best angle possible. So right here is three fingers about, right? So I put my fingers up to it, make sure there's three fingers. So now I have the frame on here, right? So the shirt's on the platen, it's lined up. It's nice and pre-treated and the frame is holding it down. So this print will take a little longer than normal because we are doing a white underbase and I also have it set to fine quality. So it's going to make sure that this is a crispier image. And once the print's done, you're gonna see how vibrant it is. It really is a nice print. While this is printing, I wanted to address a few questions and concerns some people may have about these machines. Do the prints fade? Absolutely not. I've already washed my Parkway Drive design that I did like probably 5 different times already, and it's still super vibrant, super, super vibrant. And I've also washed my Street Dwellers prints that I did already, and they also are super vibrant. So no, they do not fade. If your print fades with one wash, then you did not heat press it long enough and you didn't have it at the right temperature. So you need to learn first if your prints are fading, because that just means that you're not educated enough on it. And just go online, educate yourself, and you're gonna get way better quality results, I promise you. Another myth is that the Anajet Ricoh machines are not reliable. Complete BS. I've been printing nonstop since I got this thing and it's been working beautifully. It's such an awesome machine. So as you can see, this is the print. See, there is a little bit of white bleeding out, but that's because I didn't add a big enough choke. Some people might like that look, but what I'll probably do is reprint it and add a little bit more of a choke so the white doesn't bleed out. So now we're gonna go ahead and heat press it. Once this timer is at zero, the actual heat press will go up by itself, which is kind of nice. And I think this is what they call a clamshell heat press, but it's really, really cool. And you're gonna see it pop up in a second. To be honest with you guys, it freaks me out every time. I always jump. See, I even jumped right now. But anyway, so you wanna go ahead and bring it up and then put it back down. This isn't really a print tutorial. I'm just kind of walking you guys through so you guys can see that everything's working great. That's a beautiful print. I can wear this now. It's not gonna fade. You can't even feel it on the shirt really. So that is it, guys. The machine is working fantastic. Pretty much it for the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this like quick little update video and little kind of walkthrough on how this stuff works and how it's currently working for me. You guys can go to the description below if you guys wanna finance one of these. If you guys wanna check out Bella Canvas, or you guys wanna check out my print business or my clothing brand, all the links are in the description below. You guys don't have to do anything, but it really does mean a lot to me. That is it for this video, guys. Keep creating, keep being awesome. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.